अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितम येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। अर्थात जिसने ज्ञानांजन रूपी शलाका से अज्ञान रूपी अंधकार से अंधे हुए लोगों की आंखें खोल दी हैं, उन गुरु को नमस्कार हो। माई हार्ट फेल्ट ग्रीटिंग्स टू ऑल द रिस्पेक्टेबल पेरेंट्स। आई अक्की वर्मा इन चार्ज ऑफ मिडल विंग वॉन्ट टू वेलकम ऑल द पेरेंट्स टू द अकेडमिक सेशन 2020। लाइक वी ऑल आर फेमिलियर विद द पेंडेमिक ब्लो ओवर आर कंट्री, दिस ईयर वी आर गोइंग वर्चुअली इन एवरी स्टूडेंट्स हाउस टू मेक श्योर अ स्मूथ एंड कंफर्टेबल टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस। Change is the only thing constant. We keep this in mind and do not leave any stone unturned in making this a memorable experience for our students. We work with your support. We bring activities with your encouragement. We meet with your responses and we expertise with your criticism. In just a short span, we have undertaken a lot of activities for the benefit of the students. Be it celebrating Earth Day or knowing the hidden talent of the children, be it passion for dancing or be serving to the poor, be it a parent connecting day or be it a celebration of Jayanti, be it a day of remembrance or be it a day of innovation, our Bagrodians proved that no spread of anything could stop us from moving forth to achieve goals and success. We thank the parents for their lovely support and for their laudable efforts in motivating teachers.
With the ongoing pandemic, digital learning is a blessing in disguise. It is like the magic pill for education in this hard time. This pandemic helped us to introspect within ourselves about the future skills of our 21st century. Some of them are listed for the reference of the students. The skills include communication, collaboration, critical analysis, creativity, and many more. The time has come to step into a world of metamorphosis. A world of mix, a world of balance. Such is the education in the upcoming times, where a blended learning will take place. A bridge will be set forth between online and offline modes for better educational processes. A mix between physical and virtual world of learning will compensate to the current needs. Dear parents, as you know, nowadays our children are attending online classes and our teachers are sending study links, study modules, video recordings to the children digitally. Physical schooling has shifted to digital schooling. Digital world has become an integral part of our lives. Therefore, it is important for us to understand the digital etiquettes and more importantly, to ensure digital well-being of our children. So let us understand what are our digital etiquettes. Dear parents, when children join online class, children should enter the class for the online session with their name and class as attendance needs to be taken. Do not share the link and password with anybody who is not a part of the school. Please keep yourself on mute mode and unmute only for asking a query or giving your feedback. I also want to request to all the parents to ensure that our children are sitting in the correct posture while attending the class, preferably on the chair with the device on the table. Do not let them lie down on the bed while attending the class. Keep the modules and recordings sent to you safe. It will help the child to revise the concept by watching the concept repeatedly. And do not make the child eat during the session. As already discussed, today our children are spending more time online in front of their screens. Therefore, it is important to supervise the time spent by the children as passive screen time, that is, restrict the time spent on playing online games and for watching other online videos, as this can prove harmful for the eyes of our children. Make the child do eye exercises regularly. Also, if possible, blue filters can be used on the mobile screen to avoid harming our eyes. Please involve the children in physical activities during their free time, like dancing, doing yoga, doing any other form of exercises. Dear parents, now talking about the mental wellness of our children. During this lockdown, everybody, including the students, are in stress. They may be going through physical and emotional anxiety. So we need to also ensure mental and emotional well-being of our children. Dear parents, this time can be used as blessing to spend as family circle time. The family circle could be for an hour every day. During this time, we can do yoga, workout or meditate with our children. It can be the playtime. You can play indoor games with your children. You can share your experiences of life using anecdotes. The experiences of the places which you have visited earlier can be discussed. You can watch the photo albums together. Children can be involved in maintaining herbal garden, in cooking without fire, or they can even help with cleaning. A new skill can be learnt by you as well as the child. The most important is inculcation of values in your children, like honesty, discipline, empathy. In our school also, we lay emphasis on inculcation of values. As our school motto says, Anushasan, Shram, Atmabal. The most important value is practicing gratitude, which means being grateful for what we have. It can start with wishing everybody in the family in the morning, praying together, the children acknowledging what their parents, grandparents, siblings, households, helps are doing for them. We should make them realize to be thankful to the Almighty for all that He has given us. Dear parents, in our school, we focus on a holistic development of our child, which emphasizes three main domains, that is, scholastic development, co-scholastic development, and life skill development. Dear parents, life skill development includes helping our children become more self-aware, finding solutions to challenges and problems, thinking critically and thinking creatively, leading with empathy, and developing more on their softer skills. We are also helping cope up our children with stress and emotions. Now talking about scholastic development. Parents, we focus on overall development of the child, that is, social, physical, intellectual, cognitive and emotional development. We can call it SPICE, that is, we aim to add SPICE to the child's life. The curriculum is based on the learning outcomes. What are learning outcomes? Learning outcomes are statements that describe significant and essential learning that learners have achieved and can reliably demonstrate at the end of a session. In other words, learning outcomes identify what the learner will know and be able to do by the end of a course or a program. Learning outcomes refer to observable and measurable knowledge, skills, and attitude of the child. Dear parents, we also have a mobile app, ERP, for the effective communication between parents and the school. Through this ERP, you can check the result sheets, fee receipts, and circulars. You can also download the syllabus cum worksheet booklets, holiday homeworks, schedule of work activities done in the class, and view messages in case your child is on leave. Dear parents, you are requested to upload the latest photograph and details of the child, parent, guardian, escort, and van driver for the identity card on the ERP portal. To download the parent escort card, you can log on to our website. This is a very important card. This card will be checked by the security guard at the school gate whenever the parent, escort, guardian, or the van driver enters the school premises on all working days, including PTM days, during the functions, meetings with the teachers, principal, or office staff. Dear parents, please note, this is a glimpse of our student's diary. You are requested to fill up the pages of the student's diary, giving complete information with the latest photograph of the child. Also, please note that circulars should be acknowledged on the same page of the diary and taken out from the diary and preserved by you. Dear parents, lastly, we know that you may have questions, queries regarding fees, admissions, and academics. For each of these separate categories, we have separate email IDs. For fee-related queries, please email us on feequerynkbpsd@gmail.com. For queries related to admission, please email us on nkbpsadmissions2020@gmail.com. We also welcome suggestions from you. For academic queries and suggestions, please email us on academicnkbpsd@gmail.com. We not only engage our children in classroom training, but we also involve them in role plays, quizzes, educational movies, on-site learnings, and group discussions. We also encourage them to participate in newspaper activities and shlok ucharan. Now coming to the co-scholastic development. Dear parents, we emphasize a lot on co-curricular activities as well. These include music, dance, sports, art and craft, and work education. We also have extracurricular activities like skating, swimming, gymnastics, taekwondo, for the overall development of our children. Here are some glimpses of the activities that our children are trained on. Therefore, for a holistic development of our children, we have sports activities and scholarship tests, not only at intra and inter-school levels, but also at zonal levels. We also have workshops for our students that are necessary in today's world to make them ready and make them more confident, like cybercrime, self-defense, preparedness for adolescents for both boys and girls. Our facilitation resources include a well-maintained library, well-equipped labs such as science labs, language lab, maths lab, computer labs, a digital studio. We have well-developed activity rooms such as dance room, music room, sports room, skating rink, basketball court, badminton court. Dear parents, in the post-COVID scenario, we know that the situation will not be the same as before. Virtual online learning will become an integral part of our education. There will be guidelines and protocols issued by the government for both teaching and assessing purposes. We will be sharing the same with you when it will be received by the school. We request you all to kindly cooperate with us to follow these protocols. Now, you can watch the subject-related slides from our subject teachers. Hope to see you all soon. Till then, wishing you a very happy schooling. Please stay safe, stay healthy, and stay happy. Thank you.
Knowledge of language is the doorway to wisdom. English is not just a subject, but a language too. English, being a global language, enables one to communicate easily with fellow global citizens. Dear parents, I would like to give you an overview of the subject. English literature connects individuals with larger truths and ideas in society. Studying literature opens up a world of inspiration and creativity through stories, poetry, and plays. To enhance the fluency and pronunciation in English, it is important to lay emphasis upon the four foundations of language learning skills. The basic language skills are listening, speaking, reading, and writing, which complement each other. These are the cornerstones of learning a language. Reading skills can be improved by motivating children to indulge in reading stories, novels, and poems. Also, a dictionary is a language learner's best friend. Newspaper reading and blog reading not only improve knowledge but also improve reading skills. There are various ways to improve English. One must surround themselves in English, be it people, TV, radio, internet, etc. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. Mistakes are a part of learning process. Organize your learning so that you have some time to study and practice every day. Keep a notebook for new vocabulary. Write down the meaning, translation, examples, and even pronunciation. Make the most of your social networks to learn English. Watch TV and radio in English and read the press in English too. Fun-filled English activities are an effective way to enhance language learning skills. They offer a relaxed environment where students can practice using new words and are free to express themselves. Storytelling. While storybooks provide ample entertainment, sharing whether real or make-believe stories provide a good bonding time while helping students to develop their communication skills. Role play. It gives the students an opportunity to practice communication at different social levels. It enriches their language and communication skills. They pick up new words of the character they love and the whole new vocabulary is built. Preparing for a debate promotes proficiency in language development in ways that are challenging and exciting for the students. Newspaper activities like crosswords, glossary, comic strips, picture stories, word-wise, etc. help students to improve their skills in reading and writing. They practice how to find the main idea, how to improve vocabulary, how to form proper sentences, and how to write a summary. Through poetry recitation, children put together their ideas and feelings with the use of rhythm, intonation, and repetitions. Methods of English teaching. The structural approach is based on the structure of language, which include complex grammar rules. The direct method is often used in teaching foreign language. The learner is not allowed to speak in their mother tongue. Emphasis is laid on good pronunciation. Communicative language teaching. The focus of this method is to enable the learner to communicate effectively in various situations. Audiolingual method. It involves teaching vocabulary and grammar patterns through dialogues to enable students to respond quickly and actively to spoken language. We often make mistakes in English, don't we? Here are a few examples. My car beautiful. It should be my car is beautiful. At Monday. It should be on Monday. So these mistakes can be corrected with skill and practice. We can turn these mistakes into opportunities for learning. A different language is a different vision of life, and I hope that learning English will be a joyful process for you.
Dear parents, mathematics is a science that deals with the logic of shape, quantity, and origin. Maths is all around us in everything we do. It is the building block for everything in our daily life, including mobile devices, architecture, art, money, engineering, and even in sports. The aim of teaching and learning mathematics is to encourage and enable students to recognize that mathematics permeates the world around us, to appreciate the usefulness, power, and beauty of mathematics, to enjoy mathematics and develop patience and persistence when solving problems. Techniques of teaching mathematics can be effectively used to make learning meaningful, interesting, and permanent. Some important techniques of teaching mathematics are oral or mental work, drill work, homework, assignment, group work, self-study, supervised study, and so on. Effective strategies for teaching elementary maths are: simplify the problem, look for patterns, use objects, draw a picture, make a chart, try, check, revise, work backwards, and ponder the questions. We at NK Bagrodia Public School use various approaches of teaching mathematics to give a strong foundation to our young learners. Activities in the Maths Lab have a great role in mathematics learning and developing various skills in solving problems as well as developing creative and logical thinking. Activities in the Maths Lab is also a pure mathematics. Our students in Maths Lab do different hands-on activities in small groups to understand the concept through relevant, meaningful, and concrete activities. Practical work approach. Our young Bagrodians in this approach manipulates concrete objects or perform activities to arrive at a conceptual understanding of situation or concept. These activities can be carried out by the teacher or the students to explore the world of mathematics to learn, to discover, and to develop an interest in the subject. Mathematics involves some basic principles of assessment, such as reliability, validity, authenticity, objectivity, practicality, interpretability, and washback effect. Last but not the least, how to develop interest in mathematics. Help your child use maths every day. Familiarize yourself with learning standards. Monitor your child's maths homework. Play maths games at home, for example, Hambola. Read books that incorporate maths. Now, a good mathematical background with the knowledge of concepts and theories is essential for meeting the challenges of modern technological society. So this is all for maths. Thank you.
Social studies. Social studies is the subject that the students will be introduced for the first time in class 6. The subject, it deals with human relationships and the way society works. In class 6th grade, the social science subject is divided into three major sections. Each section is designed to make sure that the students get the basic awareness of the modern lifestyle and the previous ones as well. The classifications of the subject in social studies involve geography, which will mainly study of the physical features of the earth and its atmosphere. Civics, social code of conduct, thus making the children aware of their roles and responsibilities. And history, the study of the past events, particularly in human affairs. The social and political life focuses on various modern cultures, religions, and democracy. General aims and objectives of studying social studies. The basic aim and objective of studying social studies are as follows. First, acquiring knowledge. Second, for the development of reasoning power and critical judgment among students. Third, training in independent studies. Fourth, formulations of habits and skills amongst the children. Fifth, training in desirable patterns of conduct. And sixth, develop the national integrations and a feeling of patriotic sense amongst the group. The importance of social studies, particularly amongst the children in this elementary school level, is to help them to become a better citizens, to enable the students to understand, to participate in and make informed decisions about their world. It provides them with skills for productive problem solving and decisions making, as well as for assessing issues, making thoughtful value judgments in learning. The methods of learning social studies involve inquiry method, observation method, field trip method, and learning through concept. Apart from these other methods, it also involves stimulations, laboratory, inquiry, project, dramatizations, question and answers, field trips, discussions, lecture methods, problem solving methods, home assignments, and some other constructional methods. To make the social studies subject more interesting, here are some of the techniques through which creative teaching involves while giving import to social studies subject. What you love about it, if you are excited to learn about and teach history, your students will notice and they will benefit. Make it hands-on. incorporate them in movement, connect the past and the present. Do read alouds, make it a hands-on and move past the textbook, and particularly use the visuals. Various activity-based learning are involved while teaching social studies. This method is based on doing some hands-on experiments and activities. The students become active learners rather than passive recipients of information. The children are provided the opportunity to explore by their own so that the learning becomes joyful and long-lasting. Therefore, to make the learning of social studies more enjoyable and effective, there is a need for innovations in teaching methods. Some of the methods used to capture the attentions of the children are given as below. Lastly, the assessment tools of social studies includes the classwork, home assignments, maps, diagrams, homework, class test, and peer assessment. The main objective behind of taking such assessment tool is to measure the improvement over time amongst the students, motivate the students to study, evaluating the teaching methods, and ranking the students' capabilities in relations to the whole group evaluations.
Science is the study of nature and behavior of natural things and the knowledge that we obtain about them. Science is a system of knowledge that is concerned with the physical world and its phenomena and its unbiased observation and systematic experimentation. In general, a science involves a pursuit of knowledge covering truth or the operation of fundamental laws. As science teachers, we use different methodologies to teach different topics in science. It is to develop certain traits in our students like intellectual honesty, curiosity, humility, open-mindedness, objectivity, critical mindedness, responsibility, risk-taking, belief, and out-of-box thinking. So different approaches of teaching science are hands-on learning, role-play, visual learning, project-based learning, storytelling, dramatization, brainstorming sessions, mind maps, magical science experiments, and individualized instructions. In group activity, the students work together as a team. They work together to solve the given problem through conceptual understanding and in turn develop skills to work together. In project-based learning, the students work on changing their ideas into working model and then present it in front of the whole class. It's a completely hands-on learning. Students are also taught to take responsibility of their own environment through a number of environmental rallies that are conducted throughout the year, and also taking oath to make the Mother Earth cleaner and greener. Debate is conducted on different scientific topics so that students develop tolerance about various scientific ideas and know how to work through them. Whenever required, we can also take online sessions in which we have doubt clearing sessions, parent connect sessions, online quiz, and online test apart from the regular studies.
हिंदी भाषा ही तो हम सबको पहचान दिलाती है, हर मानव के मन के भावों को दर्शाती है। हिंदी एक प्रमुख भाषा है तथा भारत की राजभाषा भी। हिंदी के माध्यम से हम अपने मन के भावों और विचारों को स्वतंत्र रूप से प्रकट कर सकते हैं। हिंदी में छात्रों को व्याकरण में विभिन्न प्रकार के विषयों से अवगत कराया जाता है, जैसे भाषा, बोली, लिपि, पर्यायवाची शब्द, विलोम शब्द, अनेकार्थक शब्द से उनमें व्याकरण संबंधी सुधार किए जाते हैं तथा अनुच्छेद, पत्र, संवाद लेखन, चित्र वर्णन, अपठित गद्यांश जैसे विषयों में छात्र किस प्रकार अपनी वर्तनी तथा लेखन शैली में सुधार करें यह बताया जाता है। समय समय पर हिंदी विषय में विभिन्न प्रतियोगिताओं के माध्यम से छात्रों में हिंदी भाषा पर पकड़ तथा आत्मविश्वास की भावना को प्रेरित किया जाता है। हिंदी दिवस, मातृभाषा दिवस, हिंदी ओलंपियाड के माध्यम से चर्चा परिचर्चा, वाद विवाद, नाटक, कविता वाचन तथा अंतर कक्षा प्रतियोगिताओं के माध्यम से छात्रों को हिंदी में स्वच्छंद वाचन के लिए प्रोत्साहित किया जाता है। हिंदी विषय पर विभिन्न प्रकार की गतिविधियां भी कराई जाती हैं, जैसे विज्ञापन लेखन, चित्र वर्णन, जिसमें छात्र सामाजिक विषयों पर चित्रों, रंगों तथा विभिन्न उक्तियों द्वारा अपने विचारों को प्रकट करते हैं। इसमें उनके लेखन कौशल में भी सुधार होता है। छात्र नुक्कड़ नाटक द्वारा वर्तमान समय में उपजने वाली समस्याओं तथा उनके समाधानों को लोगों तक आसानी से पहुंचाकर समाज में जागरूकता लाते हैं। हमारी पौराणिक कथाओं में रामायण, महाभारत तथा कृष्ण लीलाओं को रंगमंच के द्वारा दिखाकर छात्र पौराणिक पात्रों के विषय में जानते भी हैं तथा वर्तमान समय से जोड़कर अच्छाई बुराई, सच झूठ, आदर सत्कार जैसी चीजों को समझते हैं तथा नैतिक मूल्यों के द्वारा अपना व्यक्तित्व भी निखारते हैं।
संस्कृत के ज्ञान के साथ केवल भाषा का ही नहीं बल्कि संस्कार और संस्कृति का ज्ञान भी जुड़ा हुआ है। अतः भाषा के साथ संस्कारों का बीजारोपण व संस्कृति का ज्ञान कराना हमारा प्रयास है। शब्दों का शुद्ध उच्चारण व शब्दों की स्पष्टता सिखाना, सबसे सटीक व प्राचीन व्याकरण से छात्रों को अवगत कराना, भाषाई ज्ञान के साथ साथ साहित्य से जुड़े श्लोकों व कथाओं के द्वारा छात्रों के शैक्षिक विकास के साथ साथ नैतिक एवं चारित्रिक विकास करना भी हमारा प्रमुख ध्येय है। छठी कक्षा में संस्कृत पढ़ाने के लिए कुछ इस प्रकार से विधियों का प्रयोग किया जाएगा कि छात्र खेल खेल में संस्कृत का ज्ञान प्राप्त कर ले, जिनमें प्रमुख होंगी प्रत्यक्ष विधि खेल खेल में सिखाना, दैनिक जीवन में प्रयोग होने वाले संस्कृत शब्दों के माध्यम से सिखाना, वीडियो पीपीटी के द्वारा सिखाना और कंठस्थीकरण के द्वारा सिखाना। ये कुछ इस प्रकार की विधियां हैं जिनके द्वारा छात्र आसानी से कष्ट साध्य विषय को भी ग्रहण कर लेते हैं। भाषा शिक्षण में कौशलों पर विकास किया जाना अत्यंत आवश्यक है। भाषा तभी सार्थक है जब वह चतुर्मुखी रूप से छात्र के हृदय पर जाकर के विराजमान हो जाए। अतः इसी को ध्यान में रखते हुए हमने चार प्रकार के कौशलों पर विशेष बल देने का प्रयास किया है और आगे भी इसी प्रकार हम इस पर प्रयास करेंगे। वो चार प्रमुख कौशल हैं श्रवण कौशल, भाषण कौशल, वाचन कौशल और लेखन कौशल। श्रवण कौशल जहां छात्रों को संस्कृत सुनने के लिए दक्ष बनाएगा, वहीं भाषण कौशल उनकी भाषा भी व्यक्ति को स्पष्ट करेगा। वाचन कौशल मौन वाचन या आदर्श वाचन के द्वारा संस्कृत को छात्रों के लिए सुगम बनाएगा, तो लेखन कौशल छात्रों के लेखन को निरंतर उत्तरोत्तर वृद्धि पर लेकर के जाएगा।
French is the native language of France, the only language which is spoken by more than 220 million people across the world, the only language which is taught in every continent of the world. The motive of teaching French language to the students is to make them understand and speak French, to conjugate beginner French verbs, to recognize basic French colors and adjectives, to make them write few sentences in French about themselves and their families. A lot of activities are being done in order that a student understands and speaks French language. Students participate in role plays, make PowerPoint presentations based on France and French culture. We also encourage students to take part in exchange programs where the students get opportunity to speak directly with the French natives.
Now comes examination system. Examination is conducted as per CBSE guidelines. Assessment is completed in two terms. Term 1, we have first periodic and half yearly. In term 2, we have second periodic and annual examination. Syllabus for first periodic. 25% of the syllabus will be covered in all the subjects, and the assessment will be from the syllabus covered till first periodic. If the school will open, then pen and paper test will be conducted, else examination will be online. In term 1, we have first periodic and half yearly examination. First periodic is conducted in the month of July. It is a pen paper test of 20 marks for 1 hour. These 20 marks are converted into 5 marks, and 5 marks are given for notebook submission, 5 marks are given for subject enrichment activities, and 5 marks are given for multiple assessment. That makes the total 20. Half yearly is again a pen paper test which is conducted for 80 marks for 3 hours. These 80 marks and the 20 marks of first periodic make the total 100. Plus for half yearly, 50% of the entire syllabus will be covered till half yearly, but for assessments only 10% syllabus will be taken from first periodic and 90% will be from the syllabus covered after first periodic till half yearly. Syllabus for second periodic. 75% of the entire syllabus will be covered till second periodic, and for the assessments 10% syllabus will be taken from first periodic, 10% will be taken from half yearly syllabus, and rest of the 80% will be taken from the chapters covered after half yearly till second periodic. In term 2, we have second periodic and final examination. Second periodic is conducted in the month of December. It is a pen paper test of 20 marks conducted for 1 hour. These 20 marks are converted into 5 marks. 5 marks are given for notebook submission, 5 marks are given for subject enrichment activities, and 5 marks are given for multiple assessment. The total for first periodic is 20 marks. Final examination is conducted in the month of March. It is 80 marks paper which is conducted for 3 hours. These 80 marks and 20 marks of second periodic make the total 100. Various subject enrichment activities are conducted in the classes for assessment in Hindi, English, Science, Mathematics, Social Studies, and French or Sanskrit. Some of the activities we have listed here are listening and speaking skills, practical and lab work, maths lab activities, map work and project work, newspaper activities, debate, role enactments, experiential learning, experimental learning, quiz, group discussions, projects, group activities, language lab drills, flip teaching, conversational skills, brainstorming sessions, mapping skills, creative writing skills, critical thinking skills, and demonstration experiments. Criterias for notebook submission are regularity in submission of work, assignment completion, and neatness and upkeeping of the notebooks. Now the question comes, why this change? The reason is the gradual increasing portion of content would prepare students acquire confidence for appearing in the board examination with 100% syllabus. Assessment under scholastic areas is done in English, Hindi, Maths, Science, Social Studies, French or Sanskrit, and Computers. Grade key for assessing scholastic areas is as shown on the slide. This shows the range of the marks and under that range which grade will be given. 91 to 100 will be graded as A1, 81 to 90 will be graded as A2, 71 to 80 will be graded as B1, 61 to 70 will be graded as B2, 51 to 60 will be graded as C1, 41 to 50 will be graded as C2, 33 to 40 will be graded as D, and 32 and below will be graded as E. Under co-scholastic activities, we have work experience, art education, yoga and physical education. Co-scholastic activities are graded on 3-point grading scale. A is given for outstanding, B is given for very good, and C is given for fair.